What is up, guys, and welcome back to East County Garage. Today, unfortunately, I have some bad news. Yesterday, Chewy got hit while he was riding his motorcycle, and it's looking like Chewy is okay, but unfortunately, Jasmine, his Grum, is not. So, I guess they have it at a shop right now, and we are gonna go down there, see what's going on, and then try and get his bike to his house. Dino and his mom are coming. We're gonna try and see if we can fit it in the back of their Highlander, which I'm kinda skeptical about. I don't think we'll be able to. But that's the plan. We're going to try and just get Chewy's bike home. It's only like a quarter mile from his house, so worst case, between Dino, Chewy, and I, we'll be able to push it. Fortunately, Chewy's okay. He's just a little bit sore. So yeah, we're going to go see what happens and recover the Grom. Let's get started. Your boy Dino's driving! Being very impatient and aggressive. Yeah, we'll go see what happens. Unlock the fucking door! We got Chewy. We got Jasmine's key.
I want to leave this.
He wants to leave this.
In the vehicle.
Alright, so via the use of Dino's mom's Highlander, we have returned to Chewy's house. And somehow it fit. And now we're going to pull her out and lock it away in Chewy's garage, dude. Yeah, what made it hard was the front wheel was like completely locked up.
Yeah, we got pushed into the fucking car. Oh, we're gonna turn it. Okay, just push it. It's gonna drag it.
As a tribute to Jasmine, I think Chewy's gonna name the new Doberman Jasmine. I think that's a good fitting tribute. What are you doing over there? Chewy's got some nice doges. Alright, so what happened, Chewy? Tell us the details.
Alright, so I drew up a little shitty diagram.
Let's take a look.
Alright. As you know, probably, maybe not. I got into an accident yesterday on my Grom. My first accident on a bike. I've been riding 4 months. It was not my fault at all. And it's funny because the Grom's top speed is already 65, and I got a sprocket on it, and my top speed was like 40, and I got accused of speeding. It doesn't make sense. And she never saw me, but okay.
So show us what's going on here.
Little diagram here. This is gonna be the bad driving Civic woman.
He's on the bike.
So this is me, right, on the Grom, just making my way downtown, you know, right down the Mesa Boulevard, and I have the right of way here because it's
a street. She's turning onto your street, and yeah. She has a stop sign.
So she's at the stop sign, right, and you can tell she's planning on coming from here, and she wants to go this way down this road. So she comes out. And she's looking for traffic coming from this direction and coming up here because that's where she wants to go. But she never bothered to look for traffic in the lane that she was cutting into and blocking, which is where I was.
Right.
So she kind of comes out, you know, and the quarter doesn't display it well, but she was blocking both lanes. I was actually in this lane right here.
And so she comes and she's just sitting right there.
Yeah, and
that's literally what the point of that lane is for.
Yeah, man. And like, that's what I was saying. It was kind of shitty because she's sitting there. So I'm thinking, okay, maybe I can go into the center turn lane to avoid collision. But the thing is, that's where she was supposed to be going. So I don't know if I were to go in front of her and she were to go like she was supposed to, I'd get hit and then it might be my fault. But like she's blocking it, so that's what am I supposed to do? So, you know, I didn't have that much time anyways. I was going about 30 miles an hour and like she was just sitting there. She was looking that direction, never saw me, this direction.
So she like kind of pulled out in front of you.
Yeah. Pulled out in front of me, I was already coming down, she never saw me, and then I hit her. I went flying. I'm pretty sure the first time she saw me was flying in front of her windshield.
So like, you like went on her hood?
I flew over her hood.
Oh,
I flew over her hood, and then someone who was there, my sister-in-law, said I was about a car length behind her car. So that's like 30 feet, sort of.
Yeah.
It's not bad, I mean, I've seen
Yeah, this. I mean, you look, you're standing, you're walking.
Yeah, it's just really fucking sore, you know?
Yeah.
And, you know, it's just, she was driving poorly, and I've been telling people how, like, I would have been mad because mistakes happen, accidents happen, people make mistakes, like I just said. What I got pissed about was that afterwards she accused me of speeding, which is funny because she never saw me, because the entire time I was thinking,
yeah,
oh,
if she,
like,
saw you speeding, then she should have had time to get out of the fucking way,
just
not
saying,
go in front of you.
Yeah. And I remember being pissed because, like, all I see is the back of her head. I'm like, fuck, she doesn't see me, you know? Like, and then,
and it was, like, all in, like, a split second, right? She doesn't see me, and the next second, you're like...
The whole, like, prior to actually making contact, I probably had 2 or 3 seconds to react. I couldn't do it in time.
And then she hits you, and you're, like, on the ground, and then she accuses you of speeding.
Okay.
Like, okay.
Okay, here's the thing. She didn't accuse me of speeding right away. I guess that's what she told the police. But it's funny, I'm rolling, I'm, like, screaming on the ground, you know. I just flew 30 feet, hit the floor, kind of hurt. She comes up to me, and she's like, I'm sorry I hit you. Do you want me to call an ambulance? Yes.
Yes, please. That'd be nice.
And then I walk over to the sidewalk. I was not in any position to be able to get information, and, like, I was hurting. I didn't exactly want to go to my bike and take out all my insurance and all that.
Yeah.
You
have bigger issues to deal with, like, your fucking life.
I'm sitting on the sidewalk. The paramedics show up. The cops show up. I see the cops talking to her, so I'm like, okay, they're getting her information. I should be good. And then paramedics are like, get in the ambulance. We're taking you to the hospital. And, yeah, dude, it was...
So here we are, it's the next day, you're doing good, we're really glad you're okay.
It's just, like, literally just a scrape right there, and then a little bit right here. My ass is really sore. I'm assuming I landed on my ass and rolled over. So.
But, dude, it could be so much worse. Like,
my head never hit the ground. That's, I'm really
that's
glad.
A big,
So,
that's good, though.
Hey, man,
I'm glad you're okay, too.
Thank you, man. It's a scary experience.
Yeah.
And now I don't have a bike, so...
Yeah, so what's going on with the Grom? It's pretty much total. The frame's bent, right?
The frame is bent. The, like, front, where the headlight is, and the front forks and everything just got fucking smashed in. Like...
You've probably seen the video earlier, yeah.
Yeah, I'll see. And I'll send you the pictures, too, you can see.
Yeah, for sure.
The positioning of where the car was and where my bike was.
Damn. Alright, well, as a little goodbye to Jasmine, to his Grom, we're gonna do a little bit of trivia right now. Go through some of my clips, see what we can find, but she will be missed, but she will live on, maybe, in the Doberman.
Yeah, for sure.
Alright, thank you guys for watching. Go follow Chewy on Instagram, tell him to fucking feel better.
Yeah.
Get him a Grom? No, don't, but...
I wouldn't mind
a Grom, but yeah, thank you guys for watching. We're glad Chewie's okay. Hopefully we'll get Chewie back in a vehicle soon. Maybe get another Grom. And
get another Grom.
Yeah. And then Chewie will be on the channel still doing other stuff with us like always. But unfortunately, the Grom in its current state is gone. So there will be no Grom for a while. So sorry.
Back soon.
Yeah. The rebirth.
Yeah.
Alright, thank you guys. Have a good one.
Right, for about a year now I've been looking at motorcycles and finally, my wish came true. Just about
new Kyle,
maybe two or three weeks ago. It was January 10th, and now it's like what, February 2nd? So
third, almost
third, whatever.
No, it is the third today. It's almost the fourth, dude. Get your dates right.
What the fuck? Anyways, I picked this thing up, and she's a beaut, man. You know, like I was looking at getting a bigger bike because everyone's saying you're gonna get bored of something small real quick. But you know what? These things are just so much fun, especially you gotta try and get other buddies to get into, you know? And